श्री वेदांत स्वामी महाराज एवं मंचस्थ विराजमान सन्यासी वृंद
All the mothers and all the saintly persons, all the devotees who are very eager to speak Harikatha, those who are eager to hear Harikatha, offer them obeisances, offer them appropriate obeisances. By the mercy of Guru Gauranga Gandharvika Giridhari, so we have come to this Navadvip Dham, which is non-different from Vrindavan Dham. And the parikrama has been completed without any obstacle or any calamity. So, we did the parikrama of 16 crores Navadvip Dham, the perimeter of this Navadvip Dham, 16 crores, we have done this parikrama. Especially from the lotus mouths of the great Vaishnavas, we heard the glories of the Gauradham, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's eternal abode. And we have declared that the Gauradham is non-different from Vrindavan Dham. Simply by performing the parikrama of Gauradham, one will receive automatically the benefit of performing the parikrama of Vrindavan Dham. There is no difference between Gauranga's pastimes and Krishna's pastimes. And also, there are manifest pastimes and unmanifest pastimes. When Krishna was on the planet, that is called manifest pastimes. And when Krishna disappeared from this planet, that is called unmanifest pastimes. Even today, Gauranga's unmanifest pastimes are going on. Although they are not visible to conditioned souls, the saintly persons can see them. So therefore, Gauranga's pastimes are manifest and unmanifest. So in some Brahmanda, still Gauranga is performing those pastimes.
So all these pastimes are going on in some Brahmanda.
So this is Aprakat Vrindavan, unmanifest Vrindavan also. So Gauranga's pastimes and Krishna's pastimes are going on. So Narahari Sarkar Thakur, not to be confused with Narahari Chakravarti, but Narahari Sarkar. So he has compared the Gaura Lila, contrasted Gaura Lila with Krishna Lila, and he has given a comparison and he has written the 8 verses how the Gaura Lila compares with Krishna Lila. And I want to quote one verse of Narahari Sarkar. So how Gaura Lila is going on and how Krishna Lila is going on. So in the transcendental Golok Vrindavan, in the spiritual sky, how the Gaura Lila is going on. Shri Narahari Sarkar, very Rasik Vaishnava, the spiritual master of Lochandas Thakur, he has written that in Aprakat Vrindavan or in the Vrindavan in the spiritual sky, so seeing those wonderful pastimes of Mahaprabhu, he was becoming very ecstatic. One Sakhi began to tell other Sakhi in Golok Vrindavan, "Hey Sakhi, look at our Govinda. Look at Govinda's Navadvip pastimes. Now our Govinda has become Sachinandan Gaurahari and is performing so many sweet pastimes. And he's performing very nice pastimes in Golok, in Shvetadip. Wonderful vermilion powder or saffron powder from the breast of the gopis, because Krishna embraced the gopis so tightly that all the saffron powder from the breast of the gopis applied on his cloth, and now he has become, his color of his yellow cloth has become saffron. And he is the crest jewel of all the debauchees. That Sri Krishna has taken sannyas. Look at the audacity of Krishna. He claims to be a sannyasi, but actually his saffron color is nothing but the saffron powder from the breast of the gopis when he embraced them tightly. So when Mahaprabhu took sannyas, so in Nidaya Ghat, it was very cold season. In the month of Magh, very cold season, Mahaprabhu stepped out of the house and he offered obeisance to Shachi Mata. She has become like a picture, touching her feet, keeping Vishnupriya lying in the bedroom, unconscious state, like in the influence of Yoga Nidra, Yoga Maya. Mahaprabhu with all his claws, making his heart very hard like stone, like thunderbolt, he jumped with all his clothes on in the Ganga, and swimming and dispersing the water by his long arms, he came across the other shore of Ganga and he came to the place called Katwa or Kantak Gram, which is like a thorn in the heart of the Brajavasis or Navadvipvasis. He went to the Kesava Bharati, the incarnation of Akrur, and he asked for sannyas. And then he told Keshava Bharati that yesterday night in the dream I heard one mantra. Can you please confirm this is the mantra for sannyas? And then he uttered that mantra in the right ear of Keshava Bharati. Keshava Bharati confirmed, yes, yes, my Nimai, my dear Nimai, this is the mantra of sannyas. And then immediately Nimai, he uttered the same mantra back in the ear of Nimai Pandit. Nimai Pandit was announced that he has taken the renounced order of life and he got the name Krishna Chaitanya. And then after taking sannyas, then he began to run towards Vrindavan. As soon as he took sannyas, his long hair up to the shoulder were cut and began to run to Vrindavan. Kaha mura pranata kaam murali vadan, kaha jao kaha pahu. Where is that Krishna who is? He is decorated by the flute. He is very attractive, Krishna. Whereas on his beautiful reddish lips, the flute is sitting. And he is that attractive Krishna whose face is like a lotus and moon. Where will I find that part of my life? In the absorbed in the mood of Shrimati Radhika, Mahaprabhu was running towards Vrindavan. That time Nityananda Prabhu, he consoled all the residents of Navadvip who were about to give up their life. And then so that time Nityananda, he walked a little bit ahead, and Nityananda Prabhu, he talked to these cowherd boys who were playing there that one sannyas is coming, he has taken sannyas. You should tell them, he will ask you, which direction is Vrindavan. You don't point them to the western direction. Rather, you point to them that Vrindavan is in the eastern direction. You misguide them. And this is my order. Nityananda Prabhu also entered into the heart of those cowherd boys and made them chant Harinam Sankirtan. Mahaprabhu walking there, he came and he saw the cowherd boys. They were playing the games. So that time Mahaprabhu asked these cowherd boys, you are chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. It seems that your chanting is the influence of the Ganga river, because Ganga seems to be very close and Ganga induces you to chant. Please tell me, how far is Vrindavan from here, O boys? And these boys were advised to lie, so therefore they lied, as ordered by Nityananda Prabhu, the Adi Guru. And they told him very clearly that the Vrindavan is in the opposite direction. So Mahaprabhu began to walk in the eastern direction instead of the western direction. The boys told, that time the boys misguided him. They told Mahaprabhu, oh Chaitanya, this Vrindavan has left much behind. You are walking in the opposite direction. Please go back now and you'll find Vrindavan. Mahaprabhu was absorbed in the mood of Shrimati Radhika. He was relishing the Madanakya Mahabhava Radhika. And therefore, in Mahabhava stage, Mahaprabhu could not realize that the boys are cheating him and lying to him. And he began to walk towards Navadvip Dham. And while walking, he came to the bank of the Ganges. But Nityananda Prabhu, meanwhile, he went to Shantipur and he sent a message to Advaita Acharya in Shantipur. Oh, Advaita Acharya, our Nimai Pandit is no more Nimai Pandit. He has become Krishna Chaitanya. All his hair is gone. He has taken the red clothes. He has taken the saffron clothes. Quickly come with us another set of clothes and you should greet him. Shantipur, the king of Shantipur, Advaita Acharya, sat in the boat and brought new set of dress, Bahirvas and Sanyas Dhoti, Kaupin for Mahaprabhu, and came in the boat and come through the Ganges flow where Mahaprabhu was present. Mahaprabhu.